God, Rita,
did fix on you.
God, Rita,
did fix on you.
No matter where you go,
no matter what you do,
God, Rita,
did fix on you. And it's fixed on you.
South,
he's fixed on you then.
You may be in the east,
he's fixed on you then.
You may be in the west,
he's fixed on you then.
But he's fixed on you everywhere. Oh, God, Rita,
he's fixed on you.
God, Rita,
he's fixed on you.
Ladies and gentlemen, good evening. The Dixie Hummingbirds started in 1928. It's 78 years now.
Before we go into this, something that I need to know from you.
I've been with them 68, and they were going 10 years carrying the name when I got with them.
It's all right if I ask you. I didn't hear you.
You talk about being afraid, but yet As afraid as we were, we still had courage to keep going.
The question is, do you feel good tonight?
We knew what the risk and the chances was. We was trying to do something that hadn't been done. That's opened the way for the rest of the groups that was coming. And that's exactly what we did.
Lord, teach us how.
And then while you're talking to him, don't forget to tell him this. Won't you do good? Lord God,
thank God.
Oh, keep our hands. Oh, Lord. Please don't let our hands do anything wrong. Let us all live down here together, Lord. Let us all live in peace. There is one thing happened that shook the nation. Listen. In 1963, we all know it was on the 22nd of November. Tragedy that happened way down in Dallas, Texas. Oh, I do believe the whole world will forever remember. Listen, President Kennedy, the one who fought so hard for the human race, by the hands of a medieval man today, Kennedy, sleeping cold in his grave. He was only trying to tell the world this. He said, together we just will stand. God said, divided will fall. Oh, if it's your will, let us work and go to school together, Lord. Let us all go and
But it was a great experience, and everything that seemed to have been wrong during that time has proven itself to have been right. Because that alone kept the Hummingbirds together. Kept us looking for another day that was going to be different. And that's what life is all about.
Come on, everybody, put your hands together. Come on.
Oh, way down south where we came from, in the land of the good sunshine, there's a little bird that flies around, humming all the time. One day in the spring, while the birds were humming, James B. Davis overheard. And then he decided to name his group the Dixie Hummingbirds. So we've been singing to the masses ever since we were young, our teens, riding the highways and all. we managed to sing every now and then. Most of the time when we would give a concert, we'd always run into Slim. You know, Slim could be the difference in a meal or maybe none. Slim is when you look for 300 people, you don't see but 21. But we've been singing by the master. Ooh. Ever since we went out to East, riding the highways, all our pockets clean. Who we?
Dixie Hummingbirds. Yes, the Dixie Hummingbirds.
Oh, but we love to sing.
We love to sing.
We love to sing.
We love to sing.
The group I got now, I can't refer back, but so far. If I said, guys, you remember Willie Easton? They weren't even here.
A lot of my older fellows that have passed on, you know. I have a younger group now. That's the only difference, you know.
It's a privilege as well as a pleasure to be able to sing with the Hummingbirds because they have always been my idol.
And I grew up listening to the Hummingbirds, listening to the different sounds and the arrangement that Mr. Tucker had put together for a lot of the songs in the group.
Well, I was standing by the bedside of the neighbor. Just about to cross the swelling tide, and I asked him if he would do me a favor, kindly take this message to the other side. Well, if you see my savior, tell him that you saw me. When you saw me, I was on my way. You may meet some more friends who may ask about me. Tell him I am coming home someday.
Never dream I would be with Dixie Hummingbirds. Never dream I would be singing side by side with Mr. Ira Tucker.
You know, I'm living a dream. I really am.
You got everything on there.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, great. Ezekiel saw the wheel. He saw that wheel. Way in the middle of the air. Ezekiel saw the wheel. In the middle of the air.
Yes, sir. Very nice.
Ezekiel saw the wheel. Saw that wheel way in the middle of the air. Ezekiel saw the wheel, ooh, 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 in the middle of the air.
I'm telling you once and I'm told you twice.
Don't you know
in the middle of the air?
Tell all that in sin is going to hell for rolling in dice. Don't you know
in the middle of the air?
Just see, I can Ezekiel saw the wheel. He saw that wheel
way in the middle of the air. Ezekiel saw the wheel.
Oh, oh, oh.
In the middle of the air.
And this is my guitar player for 50 years, Mr. Howard Carroll. And we are in a spot we call the Lucky Spot. A lot of good stuff have come from down here.
Full of the faith that the darkness had taught us.
When I first started to sing it, there was a light down on Golden Street that all the fellas used to meet. This is the next spot after we've gotten grown.
Just thank God for being here, to be in this lucky spot.
All right, let's go back to, well, the beginning.
Yes. 1, 2, 3, 4.
He's the most knowledgeable music teacher I have ever met.
And the records,
just listening to the different arrangements, I've learned so much.
This is my college days now, with Mr. T being the teacher.
If he gives you a chord, and if you miss one note, he can hear it. You can't get anything past him. I've tried.
The bumps. Bursting
air. We automatically know when he's giving you the eye, looking on the side of his eyes, giving you the eye saying, this is your note.
Say it again.
If you fall off a little bit, he'll turn his lips to the side and give you his note again.
He beats
it in our head. We rehearse for hours and hours.
It don't come easy. You have to be determined. You have to be dedicated. Because Hummingbirds' songs is not easy to sing. You have to practice.
Wait.
You never get too old to learn. But you know, you always have to learn from somebody. Everything you know is somebody else's experience.
And the home.
Can't go wrong with him teaching you, the icon, teaching you the greatest music ever, the gospel, legendary gospel.
Okay, good. All right. Right here, we're going to feature Brother William Bright. He's going to do a selection entitled Born Again.
Come on, everybody, put your hands together. I got a little story I want to tell you. Everybody, come on. Little bit louder. had heard about it, but I never felt it. This manner it come down from above. When the life of sin I can no longer stand, I went to my mother and asked her, how can I get to know the man? Said there must be, can't you see? Nicodemus was the ruler of the Jews. He was a Pharisee and a good teacher too. But Nicodemus didn't teach his people when they gathered around the steeple. What's born of the flesh is flesh. What's born of the spirit is spirit. Nicodemus was a good and an educated man. So the Lord told Nicodemus, this is one thing you must understand. He said there must be, can't you see? Oh, you got to be born.
Be born again.
You got to be born again. And this is what I'm talking about. Children,
you must
got to have that
fire and Holy Ghost.
That thing that
keep the
prayer with
the prayer with time.
Kind
of religion you cannot conceal.
It'll make
Love Your Fellow Man, that's my favorite song. That's my most favorite song because I really like the message that song gives.
It does something to my heart. It does something to my soul. It gets down deep inside that it goes to have something to do with everybody. It got something to do with everybody as a whole.
This one is entitled Love Your Fellow Man. Tugging at my heartstring, it keeps running through my mind. Yeah, the way of salvation is never hard to find. Love your fellow man.
and some are born to lose. Oh, don't you try to judge a man until you walk in his shoes. Well, if you want to go to heaven, then you got to understand. Find he's understanding. Help him to mend his way.
Wanted them to sing together. Linda, my youngest daughter, and Sandra is the oldest daughter. I always wanted them to do something with their father, knowing that he had talent, you know, and I just wanted, but I could never pull them together. Believe it or not, today is the first time I ever heard them in my whole life, you know, do anything at all together.
You know, my grandfather used to do some when I was about 5 or 6, maybe 8 years old, and I used to listen to him do Shouting Around the Walls of Zion. And I just like to touch that a little bit. Can you help me do it, baby?
I can help you.
Okay.
We'll shout and go around. Shout and go around. We'll shout and go around. Shout and go around. We'll shout and go around the walls of Zion.
All right.
Help us to get out there tonight and sing and let it come from the heart.
Yes, Lord.
We're very happy to be here with you this evening. I'm happy to be anywhere at this point.
Each night, you know, kind of carries a little different vibe. It all depends on the crowd, the feeling.
Gift for the soul, gift for the spirit. Took me back to my roots. You know, like, grew up in the church and almost got teary-eyed.
It's
it's wonderful for me, kind of as the host, to be able to share this wonderful musical group with my fellow Kauaians, but also to be able to provide for the Dixie Hummingbirds this audience that just was ecstatic. I mean, they were jumping and shouting and praising Jesus, and the most fun of all was had by Glenn, the minister of Church of the Pacific, because here's a bunch of people who paid $15 to come in and praise the Lord.
This program was really fantastic.
I was ready. When you said I was ready to preach, I'd say, preach on, brother. But there's nothing that brought the kind of blessing to the diverse group of people that came to that. I mean, 80% of the people there, I didn't know. And that's what you like. That's what you want in the church. He opened up the door of God's love.
Inspiration. True inspiration.
Yeah, music just keeps coming through. I've always wanted to go to a gospel church, and I never really made it.
Yeah.
And this is it.
Hey, thank you for being here.
Surely.
Excellent.
May God bless you. And you have certainly blessed me on this special birthday here.
Thank you.
Michael, all right.
Thanks for talking about the Lord.
Thank you. Thank you.
This for the baby over there.
She loved it. Oh, yeah. Yeah, she's part gospel. She's got it in her soul now. Yeah.
Thank you.
are so privileged. We're so honored to have our special guest with us this morning, the Dixie Hummingbirds. Isn't that all right? And you all are experiencing Black history in the making. And you all are part of it, young people. Isn't that all right?
All right.
What does the word endurance mean?
To keep going.
To keep going. Now, if you look in the dictionary and look up the word endurance, you see the word Dixie Hummingbirds. Don't you?
All right.
All right.
A pioneering force behind the evolution of modern day gospel music. They earned almost universal recognition as the greatest Southern quartet of their generation. And it's praise music. And we enjoy it, and it just touches your soul in a different way.
Right.
And it was created by us and for us, and we now share it with the world.
This one is entitled, Lord, Don't Let Me Fall Down by the Wayside.
Surely gonna leave
down by the wayside.
this blessing.
Thanks for this blessing.
Thank you for our guests.
Thank you for our guests.
Bless our pastor.
Bless our pastor.
And our friends.
And our friends.
Amen.
Day of maybe it was the 60s, we put out a song called A Christian's Automobile. Yeah. So let's take a little ride in the Christian automobile. Oh, you know that
every time
I'm gone. Running
just like an automobile.
And every time
I'm
running for
just
Jesus,
like an automobile.
Every time I'm running for
just
Jesus,
just like an automobile.
And no prayer. To glory, Satan is gonna try to flag you down, but
keep on driving if you want your star.
Oh yeah, you got to check on your tires. You got a rough road ahead. When you are weary from your journey, God will put you to bed. You got to check on your brakes. Stop your wicked ways. A man or of a woman has only got a few days. And you got to check on your lights so you can see your own fault. Stop by, you can see them. Your soul will be lost. Check on your batteries for that charge to keep your hair. And if you keep that charge, you'll make it over there. Check on your generators. You need more strength and power. You can't do nothing without the man. You need him every hour. Check on your radiators. Water to be baptized. Then your soul will catch on fire. Check on your gasoline. Have enough to make it in. That means you got to repent, children. Stay away from sin. Check on your engines. You got to keep them clean. Your body is God's temple. I know you know what I mean. Well, now, everybody got a race to run. The gamblers in the streets, the policeman that walk on his beat, the lawyers, the doctors, the teachers, the preachers, and everybody got a race to run. But you don't have to speed. Trust in Jesus. Trust him in the morning. Trust him in the evening. Trust him in the midnight hour. Trust in Jesus. He'll give you what you need. This is just one more thing that I would like to say. Keep on driving on up the King's Highway. For Highway 99 just won't do. It's got to be 100 to take you through. If you see a detour, you better stop and check. It might be the devil trying to make you wreck. Drive through a rain, drive through a storm. Don't choke down, and you got a brand new home. Christian. daughter, start your automobile. Put it in first gear and go on up the hill. Drive on, children, when your pedals get heavy now. Drive on, when your friends turn against you. Drive on, children, if I never see you no more, I'll meet you when I pull in on the other shore. I'm not worried about my parking space. I just want to see to my Savior face to face. You know,
prayer is a driver's license.
Well, faith.
I drove for 18 years from here to Miami. I was a driver. When I get there, I get in my room and everything, and then go fishing. That place is infested with alligators, man.
Let the church say amen.
Whole lot of alligators there. We live in Sawgrass. One was easing up on us. I left my pole and everything. The alligator got my hat, took it to his nest, and stood back and looked like he said, well, you're next, you know.
God gave you what you have today.
Listen to the words. Listen to the words.
Jesus. Jesus. You know that he gave. Surely he can take it away.
Listen. This is one thing I want you to remember. Before you get too high, there is no amount of money that'll keep you here.
You got to lay down and die. Take it away.
as a child, I always fascinated, I had a fascination about being a gospel bass singer, and it's sort of a touch of faith that I became one.
I would say about a year and 2 months ago, I was doing an interview at WRTI in Philadelphia, Temple University. And when we broke for a few minutes, this young man walked in and said, "Good morning."
He asked me if I sang at all. And I said, well, I dabble here and there, nothing professional, just more so just for fun. And he asked me, would I be interested? And I said, well, I'm still in college, and I still have 2 years left to go.
He said, you're still rehearsing? I said, yeah. Can I come to one of your rehearsals? I said, yeah. He beat us there.
I was sort of thrown into the flames, however. After the first rehearsal, it was that same night we had a show, and I performed on that show.
You want to hear him? Yeah. All right. Mr. Cornell McKnight.
Yeah.
because he'll understand it all. The lows that he'll understand it all.
How y'all doing tonight? Y'all doing all right? I said, was that all right?
See, he'll understand. Yes, he'll understand it all right. The lows that he'll understand it all.
Mind if I go down?
Would you mind if I go down?
Y'all want me to go down one more?
I can't hear you.
He'll understand it all.
Bye.
He is 21.
Sing, I have learned to sing with feeling. I got to put myself into it. I move around.
Over the hill and everywhere.
I just can't stand in one place and sing. I like to get involved with the people. I like to get out there with them and hold a conversation just like I'm holding with you, only I'm singing.
That sounds pretty good. Come on, do it again.
I like to get the people involved. Talking back to me, I ask them, do you feel, and they'll respond back to me, well, let me see you wave your hand, do you feel all right? You know, it's a wonderful feeling. Singing and music is universal, and it's a beautiful communication with people.
Feature Mr. William Bright and Mr. Cornell McKnight, and they are going to say to you, go tell it on the mountain.
I'm dedicating this song to Brother Walters and his wife. God bless you.
Woman, go tell it on the mountain.
Y'all mind if I come down here?
My Lord.
Over the hills
and everywhere,
go
tell on the mountain
how Jesus Christ is born. Say it again for me, y'all. Tell you this, listen. When I was a seeker, I sought both night and day.
Come on! Oh, 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 get homebound, get over the hills, son, it's your turn. You go ahead. You tell him.
He made me Lord a watchman.
Come on, son.
Upon the city wall. And if I, Lord, am a Christian, I am the least of
Now let me hear you, come on!
And everywhere goes.
Sound pretty good!
Tell it on the mountain, our Jesus Christ.
Sound all right to me? Hey, Brother Bane, give me a hand, son! That sound pretty good. Do it again, do it again, do it again.
A certain the roots of Americana.
Let me hear what your version is.
What's our? Do we have a version? Yeah. What key we in? You don't even have to scratch the surface. You just come near it, and you realize that there is not a separation, and the voices come together, and that coming together of voices that is the sound of America.
Well, the king got angry and didn't agree, but finally he set the people free. Changed his mind all on a whim and sent his men gone after them. Oh, Mary, don't you weep, don't you moan. Oh, Mary, don't you weep, don't you moan. The Pharaoh's army already got drowned. Mary, don't you weep.
You know, it's a nice place where African, American, and Jewish music intersects is in these songs about freedom and songs about escaping bondage and songs that we associated with Passover.
He finally caught them on the banks of the sea. The people called on the power that be and God told Moses what to do to lead those Hebrew children through. Oh, Mary, don't you weep, don't you moan. Oh, Mary, don't you weep, don't you moan. Pharaoh's army already got drowned. Mary, don't you weep.
They're similar to us in a way, but singing within their style was just unbelievable. Inside an entire wonderful gospel group, and incredible to be like really inside the rhythms of musicians like that.
Oh, Mary, don't you weep, don't you mourn. Oh, Mary, don't you weep, don't you mourn. Pharaoh's army already got drowned.
The sense of spirituality, that music has a higher purpose. See, that's the other thing that, that is instantly makes us come together.
Yeah. Gonna lay down my burden.
Down by the riverside. Down by the riverside. Down by the riverside.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Last man wobbling.
Last man wobbling, man.
Time marches on. But I'm just thankful that I've been here 68 years.
He's 81 years old, and he has more time behind him than he has ahead of him. I just want to help carry on that legacy.
Oh, Jesus Christ is born.
He tells us all the time, he's like, hey, you know, I know my time is limited. He said, but I want to know that when I'm gone, the hummingbirds will continue. And that's our goal.
Thank you. That was really great.
Thank you.
Without him, we wouldn't be here. He's accomplished so much. He can just as easily say, well, guys, that's it. But he loves what he does. And most of all, he loves the energy that we give him.
But the same Jesus, same your soul, that ain't all.
It's endless. And they're handing the baton over all the time, but everybody wants to go to the source. And the absolute source is the Dixie Hummingbirds.
But I'm gonna try to do this one for you because, you know, it's a blessing.
Take your time, son.
To be here tonight. And for me, blessing for me to be anywhere. But I thank God that he let me be with the hummingbirds for 68 years. You know, I feel good tonight.
Oh, yeah.
I'm 81 years old.
Come on.
But I want you to come on and go along with me. I got to say these words.
All right, I want everybody, come on. Everybody, clap your hands. Listen, stand up on your feet, everybody.
Just remember, Jesus is near.
still as the bat. She's as still as the bat.
I'm serving all tonight.
She's as still as the bat.
Serving all tonight.
She's as still as the bat.
I know we're able.
She's as still as the bat.
Gonna get me the rest.
She's as still as the bat.
All the way.
She's as still as the bat.
All the way.
She's as still as the bat.
Time to smile.
She's as still as the bat.
Get it glory.
She's as still as the bat. Just
A few years ago, the Dixie Hummingbirds and I and Stevie Wonder recorded a version of Loves Me Like a Rock, and that's what we're going to do in a second. When I was a little boy,
when I was just a boy,
and the devil called my name,
when I was just a boy,
I said, now who do,
ooh,
who do you think you're fooling?
When I was just a boy,
I'm a consecrated boy,
when I was just a boy, ooh.
Singer in the Sunday choir, mama loves me, she loves me, she get down on her knees and whoa, she loves me like a rock.
You know my Jesus never failed.
I'd like to say congratulations to you, Mr. Ira Tucker, and the celebration of all of you as the Dixie Hummingbirds celebrating your 80th year anniversary.
With the Hummingbirds, that you talk about their 80th anniversary, which is in itself a miracle and wonderful.
You can't celebrate 80 years unless you're doing something really special for 80 years, touching people's hearts, touching their souls, and making them feel like they're inspired, and that's exactly what they've done.
Those are the people who have music in their blood, not just mind, but in their blood. They enjoy it. They're not just singing for the people, but they enjoy it.
So the millions of people that have been inspired and been encouraged and uplifted by this group, on their behalf, I'd like to say happy 80th anniversary.
And, you know, here we are today at the Warner Theater, here with the legends, the Dixie Hummingbirds.
It's going to be an eventful evening.
Yes, it is.
Ladies and gentlemen, James Taylor and the Dixie Hummingbirds.
Slip sliding away, slip sliding away. You know that they're nearer their destination the more you slip sliding away.
Paul called me up and he said, listen, I want you to sing, and I've got the Hummingbirds, Ira and the Dixie Hummingbirds, that are gonna sing on the same tune. And I said, you know, that's what you get, you see, and you never know where things are gonna lead you. So it's excellent to be, you know.
Yeah, and it's coming something real good too, man, each time.
Yeah, that's right.
It seems to be getting better.
Just the side of the world. Slip sliding away, slip sliding away. Oh, the nearer your destination, the more you're slip sliding away.
Yeah, Ira, I thank you. You know, it's been a great, has been a real treat to work with you gentlemen in this on this thing, and it's been the surprise event bonus element to this thing for me. Yeah.
Slip sliding away. Dixie Hummingbirds, slip sliding away. We know the nearer your destination, or we slip sliding away.
It is always an honor to be with Hummingbirds. The influence that they had on Paul writing this song, and just the whole spiritual place of what the song is talking about, I do believe, guaranteed, that success that was from this song. And it is great to have the pleasure of performing with, singing with, the Dixie Hummingbirds.
Stevie Wonder.
When I was a little boy,
when
the devil called my name, consecrated boy, singer in a Sunday choir, mama loves me, she loves me, she get down on her knees and hug me, and she loves me like a rock, she rock me like the rock of ages, and love me, she love me, love me, love me.
I've grown to be a man,
I've
Ira Tucker.
Never would call my name. I'm saying, who do? Who do you think you're fooling? I'm a consummated man. I can bet you a little pretty. I'm a full of meat. She loves me. Got back to my knees. Her face to love me like a rock.
President, they haven't got my name. I'm sorry. No, you know what? I'm sorry. I don't have my cue cards.
Credit boy. Singer in a Sunday choir. My mama loves me. She loves me. She get down on the knees and hug me. She loved me like a rock. She rocked me like a rock of ages and loved me. Love me, love me, love me, love me.
I'm grown to be a man.
Oh, Ira Tucker.
Christian. Christian. Turn on your starter, start your automobile. Put it in first gear and go on up the hill. Drive on, children, when your pedal get heavy now. Drive on, when your friends turn against you. Drive on, children, if I never see you no more, I'll meet you when I pull in on the other shore. I'm not worried about my parking space. I just want to see you. See my Savior face to face, you know. Prayer is a driver.